when I was younger, I tried to make some wine. That didn't really work out real well. But it made good vinegar. I could say that. I'm Craig Sean. I'm the vineyard manager at Monte De Oro here in Temecula, California. As a kid, I used to have a garden down the street. I grew corn, I grew watermelons. And out here in Temecula, we don't have tomatoes, but we do have grapes.
Making wine is pretty easy. It's dealing with what Mother Nature hands you. I'm David Albright. I'm the winemaker here at Monte De Oro. Been here since 2009. That's when the winery opened. As it happens to be now, I'm more and more every day becoming a farmer because that's the vineyard part of it. That's really where it starts, is in the vineyard. If you don't have great grapes, you really don't have anything. This year we got a surprise in that we had a lot of rain for the winter, like we've never had before. Water's a big thing here in Southern California. We really didn't need that rain then. That brings on mold and mildew. And I've often wondered, you know, when I walk through the vineyards and I'm counting, you know, you see diseases, different things, and you're like, wow, it would really be neat to have an overall aerial perspective. Because see, I do that now all by myself, where I will walk through a vineyard every year and thousands of vines. Imagine counting. And it's not easy. And that's just one step of it.
A lot of times we can't get somebody out to the vineyard right away. If we don't get somebody out to the vineyard right away, that problem will start spreading.
Precision agriculture has been around since the 80s with the advent of satellite imagery. And over time, that's expanded to manned aircraft, that's expanded to drones. And now with everything packaged into a small, concise unit, that opened up the door to so many new users to be able to get their hands on this and flight the same day and collect very high quality data and being able to process that in some tailor-made solutions so that growers, and in this case, we're at a wine grape vineyard here, they can use a very specific software and identify and quantify certain issues that are currently taking place here in this vineyard.
So using something like the Mavic 3 Multispectral, we can now fly over that week over week, if not day over day, and we can start tracking trends of that stress. Instead of walking around potentially aimlessly, trying to find what that stress is, we now know where to walk and have a guided tour, and now we can start focusing on the problem and what the solution may be.
At the beginning of the year here in Temecula, vines are dormant. And then come about February, we have to start pruning back the old canes from last year. As we're pruning those back, we have the crew inspecting the vines for health. Then they have to start spraying them. Then about March, we start seeing bud break. And bud break is where you get the little green leaves starting to come out. Then you start seeing the little tiny grapes, little tiny things, very, very small. And the vines get greener, the canopy gets bigger. Then we get close to harvest. Harvest, we stop spraying. As the grapes get more and more sugar and the pH level comes up, then we start to harvest.
If you had a camera and you could follow me, I'd probably just take you into the lab. The lab is something that, you know, I had to go back to school for. You're compiling data, so we're dealing with acid, we're dealing with pH, we're dealing with sulfites, and so with a lot of tests in the lab that I run, the lab is its own world.
The biggest piece of the pie that it seems like we're missing that DJI is helping to develop is having that all-in-one solution where you have hardware, you have software, you can analyze the data, and then kick the analysis over to a third-party solution like Aerobotics.
So this is an entirely automated process. With the controller, you have a screen, you plan out your mission by drawing a polygon around the boundary of your field, if you will, and your drone's gonna fly in essentially a lawnmower flight plan across the field. And it's very simple to do with a couple taps on the screen and you're off and running.
They can pinpoint areas where there's stress in the vines. You know, you can kind of look at it from the ground, but the aerial view seems a lot better to me, and you can really tell the difference in good areas and bad areas.
Once the drone finishes its mission, then you pull that SD card, and that's where all the gold really is, all that information. You plug that into your laptop, and that's where we get into the analytics within these softwares.
As far as being precise, you can pick exactly the areas that you need to focus on rather than just have a tractor running up and down the vineyard.
One of the biggest game changers of utilizing drones and multispectral sensors has been the frequency of data capture. We go from week to week or maybe even month to month on analyzing these vineyards. And if we can capture centimeter level data day to day, we can start doing trend analysis and from there make much smarter management decisions.
I mean, every field has a story to tell, right? So this is a way in which we can kind of understand what the crop is saying. So we can capture that data with this unit, run it through a software, and we can easily understand or start to understand certain features, certain variances, certain issues, certain impacts. And it's going to paint a very clear picture as you see these variances taking place across a field.